Well, good morning and welcome to St Mary's Church on this All Saints Day. Hence the goal, right, to remember all those saints, remember a lot of saints that are named. As we had just a week or so ago, and people remember all the saints, including our very own together, but all those, including ourselves among the saints, because in the early church, everyone was known as the saint of God. Life is about to change again as we go into a national lockdown. Next Sunday is Remembrance Sunday. And we're going to have a risk assessment meeting after this service in order to plan for what we do for Remembrance Sunday. But that is now, well, we're going to rethink the whole thing. I don't quite know what we're going to do. I suspect that we'll do something online and then have the remembrance around the wall. But I'll send out an email to say exactly what we're doing during the week. It is a difficult time for everyone, so we do need to keep each other encouraged, supported, however we can. Other notices are there for you. We are going to keep the church, we are having the Eucharist at Trinity on Wednesday. Please do book or bring Kate if that's difficult for you, give her a ring and she'll book you in. And also, St Mary's will be open from 12 to 4, if anyone's going to have a poppy or a remembrance class or just come sit and pray, then it will be open on Wednesday. And also, just to remind you that this week there are a couple of opportunities for Bible study online. There's the Bible study on Wednesday, which is being led by Bassett, and that's for the deanery, using the Bible Society course. And also on Thursday the 5th, there is a Bible study that Jenny and Steve Corby are leading. And the details are on your sheets. So please use this opportunity. We can't go out and do anything, but we can do things online. It's an opportunity to do some Bible study.
Firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love. Have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you with all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you.
In Revelations. After this, I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white, with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God, who is seated on the throne, and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. And they fell on their faces before the throne and worshipped God, singing, "Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honour and power and might be to our God for ever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these, robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one that knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of the water of life. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
So may the words that I speak in the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable to our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Patron saint of lost causes, because he was not afraid. emulation of Martin Luther, who may not have a saint before his name, but who in the 5th century became the spark for the Reformation and the Protestant Church. And in the coming week, remember the work of various bishops and missionaries, a hermit, and one of my favourite mystics, Marjorie Kemp, who was contemporary with Julian of Norwich, who argued with the church authorities in the strength of her visions and her convictions, and undertook many pilgrimages in response to Christ's messages. And at Saint's Day, I miss most, because it clashes with our Remembrance Day, is that of Martin of Tours, the Roman soldier who shared his cloak with a beggar and turned to be a faithful follower of Christ in establishing service to the poor and becoming a bishop. We had a lovely candlelit parade in Tabern in our village in Germany, ending with a gathering in the hall where the children were given a small gift from St. Martin. But in examining those lives and the lives of others, where will we put ourselves? Because there are saints with a small s. Are there saints in our own lives whom we can look at and say, this person has given me a good example of how to live a Christian life? This person has tried in his or her life to be a pattern of the image of Christ. There are many who are like this. And my personal story is of my grandmother in Welsh, my Mam Gi. We lived in her house in the early years of my life to the age of 12. And we as a family and as children and grandchildren were brought up to believe that Jesus was part of our lives. He was our brother. He was present at our meals. He was present in the things we did in our day-to-day lives. He wasn't out there. He was in here. And recently I found my certificate to say that I joined the Sunday school at the age of 6 weeks. I don't know how much I missed from then, but I collected the stamps and books. Some of you may remember that, with pictures of Jesus and the verses. And so we look to people, perhaps in our families, perhaps in the outer world, perhaps those Sunday school teachers who taught us about Jesus, and the clubs we might have gone to as children to learn about Jesus' life and ministry. All these I would regard as saints with a small s. And we have that vision that Paul gives us in his writings. And he calls us the body of Christ. We are the body of Christ. And through the strength of the Spirit, we must have faith in Christ and love towards one another, that through the grace of God, we will still be within the body of the church and receive those gifts that we need to enable us to work together to his glory and the growth of his kingdom. And what about this gospel reading today? It too is a reminder of those blessings that we have if we live according to God's will. And high on our list is our attitudes and actions towards those who are always a concern of the Old Testament as well as the New. That God is looking for justice and mercy towards the weak and the vulnerable, the poor, the hungry, the widow. And these people are as much in these lands, in this space, as much as in the past and in the third world countries today. The body of Christ is eyes and hearts open to each other and to the world outside. It is a challenge that can seem overwhelming. But how can we achieve our role? Jesus gives us this set of values that we call the Beatitudes. And I read in a book a long time ago this version of the Beatitudes that concerns not just us as individuals, but the wider world and of God, our relationship. felt in the present time here in our lives, and with all that we say and do in this time, knowing in our hearts and minds that the presence of God sustains us throughout our time here on earth. And in our picture of Revelation, those who sacrifice their lives so they live the life that Jesus has demonstrated for us, will, at the time of their passing, receive that glory of life with God and with Jesus and their fellow companions forever. And that life will be joyful in their thanks for all they have received from God through the life and sacrifice of Jesus. This morning I had to write a PS to this sermon, having heard the news of a new national lockdown. We know that many will encounter extreme difficulties in business, work and family life, and the impact may be severe for some. So what can we do as the body of Christ in this place and in the world? Remembering that teaching of Jesus, the Beatitudes, and being alongside others as he is alongside us, our prayers and actions will be more important than ever. And with the help of God, we will maintain our community in prayer and charity through the coming weeks.
churches are my lighthouse. Lord of the saints, strengthen already long known for Henry Warren, Jennifer Fenton, Alice Keaton, John Couch, Norman Gould, Kate, Jackie Best, and all who have been here. Lord,
there must be love, to bind all together, complete the whole. Let the peace of Christ rule in our hearts.
And the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And
peace be with you. Serve on earth and worship you now in heaven. We raise our voice to proclaim.
trembled in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, and is gathered in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. And as we follow his example and obey his command, granted by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and his blood. Who in the same night he was betrayed, took bread and gave him thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Same way after supper, he took the cup and gave him thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." To you be glory and praise. Of our shepherd.
thanks and praise, that when we still far off, you met us.